Hello everyone, welcome to iLLPhoCorPhics. Now today we are starting another exciting Adobe Photoshop tutorial. Now today I'm gonna show you how can you create Roility White tone color effect in Photoshop. This is an awesome color grading technique to create any kind of image into awesome Roility White tone color effect. And stay till the end of the tutorial and learn how can you create this awesome Roility color tone effect, and you can also apply these things on your own image. And if you are new, welcome. Make sure to subscribe and also press that bell icon, because I'm going to come up more exciting Adobe Photoshop tips, tricks and tutorials for you. So without any further ado, let's jump to our Photoshop. Now we are here, the magical world of Photoshop. You can see this beautiful image, and I just love this image so much. So if you want this image, just check the link in the description. I will put that so that you can download this beautiful image. To create this white tone color effect, I have another image if I show this one, and I'm going to first make this color tone in this image, and I'm gonna show you then how can you apply this one to same thing to create this white tone color effect. To do that, just first you go to the one and make a duplicate layer, take it here and down here. You can also press Ctrl or Command J, it's a shortcut key, create add a new layer. Now press right button on your mouse, and you can see this is convert to smart object, because I'm going to work non-destructively, and I always prefer you to work non-destructively, and I really love to work non-destructively. If you follow me for a long time, you know that I really love to work non-destructively. So that now first I just create this one, then next to go this filter, camera filter, and I'm going to use to create this awesome Roility white and color effect. I'm going to use the camera filter, and I'm going to do this step by step. So do that first. What I'm going to do, I'm going to trying to color effect on this basic slider. Just decrease this temperature around 10, minus 10 or something like that, and increase the tint a little bit, just 5 or something, plus 5 around this one. This is perfect. Now we just create some of the effect to create this our Roility effect. To do that, now the next thing what I'm going to do, I'm going to increase the expose, you can see around 40 something like that, and I think this is perfect. Then I'm not going to touch contrast or highlight in this case. This time I'm going to use this shadow white and black slider. Now increase the shadow around 30, then increase the white around 30 something like that, then increase also the black just around 30. Now why I am doing the same thing, because I'm using this Roility color tone effect for my image. So I just increase these three slider, you can see these three slider are same to balance overall white tone color effect. Now we are done in here. The next thing, go to this tone terms. Now if you go to this one, you might be find it in the parametric one. Go to this one to point. Now take the point. Now first make a point here, it's like a curve. If you're using in a Photoshop curve, it's pretty much the same, but it's different. Now just increase this one around something like that, don't increase too much, and I think this is perfect. Then take a point here, because it's too much highlight, we don't want too much highlight, so decrease this a little bit, and this middle point, and it's okay. Then take another point here, decrease the gray color of this one, the mid-tone, a little bit like this one, and increase this, you can see this one, just increase this one around like that. You can see the difference why I'm increasing this one, and now we just created our this one. The next thing, we need to balance over color, because there is so much magenta, yellow, and also the greenish, it's not looking the Roility color of it. To fix this one, just go to this HL adjustment, you can see HL adjustment, that's mean the hue, saturation and luminous adjustment layer. Now come to this saturation, we don't want to touch the hue, we're going to touch only saturation and luminance. Now first decrease the reds, there is so much red on here, around 10 something like that, I think 10, I'm going to with the 10. Also decrease the orange around 10, the same thing, and I think just increase this one to 10. Then take the yellow down around 80 something like that, around 80. Also decrease the green around 80, just do the same thing, and I think this is great. Now we just create some of this color, royalty color effect, then also decrease the aquos around 70, something like that, 70 already. This is okay. Then also decrease the blue a little bit around 65, and just a little bit, and I think this is perfect. And then also decrease the purple and around 50, and do the same thing also magenta a little bit. Now this okay, we just decrease our saturation. The next thing, we need to increase the luminance of our color. To do that, just increase the red luminance around 10, also orange around 10, something like that. Then come to the aqua and greens, just increase them around 50 or something like that, around 50. I'm going to do the 50 also. Aquas, I don't want to touch the green up too much, just aquas a little bit more, also blue around 40, something like that. Now we are pretty much done. We just good. Now if you think that you want to more sharpening, something like that, you can add the sharpening. And most of the people are like some of the blurriness in a royalty white tone. So if you want to add some royalty, just go to this basic adjustment and decrease the contrast. You can see the contrast, just decrease it. And most of the people like to add some of the contrast in your image. You can increase this one and you can use this more sharpening. But in this case, I would like to add some of the blurriness into image, and I really love the white and color effect, some of the blurriness, so it's look awesome. Now you can see we just created our awesome effect. Now this is okay. The next thing, I'm going to save this one because I'm going to use the same slider effect into another image to show you that. Just go to this three icon and then you can see the save setting. We're going to save all the settings from our next image. Just save setting. Now they do the same thing well, and now save. Now save it anywhere you like to add. In this case, I would like to save in a place where I find the desktop, then save it. Then just hit OK and OK. We are done. Then you can see the before and the after one. This is the before and the after one. We just created our variety white tone color effect, and how cool it is. You can see I just love this editing, and some other time I will use on my own portrait, and if you can use this one your own portrait. Then come to the next one. This one I'm going to use the same setting for this one. Just take this one, press Ctrl or Command J to make a duplicate layer, and right button your mouse and convert to smart object. We just convert it, then go to the filter, camera filter. We here the next thing, just press this three dots here and load setting. We're going to load this setting what we saved in before, just this one we saved in desktop, and open. Now we just created our white and color effect. Now if you need to adjust some of the color, you can easily do that. Some of the time you can use any kind of color effect. If you want the contrast back again, you can do that. If you like to add more blurriness, something like this one, you can do that. It depends on you. Whatever this one, you can easily play with and create awesome effect. Now just hit OK. Now some of the time you need some of the bluishness in your image to royalty color effect, you can easily add this one. Just go to the tone curve. You can see we just use the point curve, so just change the channel. There is RGB channel, change it to blue and increase the blue a little bit, something like this one, around this one. And we just say okay, now we are done. Just hit OK, and you just see how can easily you can create this awesome white and color effect. Just see the before and the after one, how super easy and cool way we just create this white royalty color effect. And I will put the link of this setting. If you want to download, you can download this one easily. So that's, I hope that you're gonna like this. So back to this our normal again, and this is okay. And I hope that you like this. You can see this beautiful image we just created, royalty white and color effect. You can use any kind of portrait, any kind of image, and you can also your own image to create this awesome royalty color effect. So that's for today, and I hope that you like it. If you like this tutorial, hit that like button. If you learn something from this tutorial, just make sure to subscribe my channel and also press that bell icon. And guys, please support me to grow up, because I'm new and I'm really want to get my first 1,000 subscribers. So guys, help me to get this one and help me to grow up. You can also share my tutorial. You can also follow me on Twitter. And what do you think about my tutorial? Just leave it in the comment section. I want to know. And you can also check out my other exciting and awesome Photoshop tutorials. I hope that you're gonna like this one. So that's for you today. See you on the next tutorial. Till then, bye. And the most important thing, keep learning.